pludselig. Jeg kunne ikke nå til en kamera, fordi mit batteri var lige lav. Mit batteri var ved at løbe tør for strøm. Så jeg ville spare på det. Jeg nåede lige at tænke, nu skal jeg til at tænde min kamera. Så lige pludselig ud af det blå, så kommer der en bok. Og jeg har slet ikke hørt den. Så jeg kunne ikke. Den store kigge, den kom gående mod mig. Og den kiggede på mig, så jeg turde ikke at tænde kameraet. Og jeg tænkte, jeg ville hellere tage skuddet. Skal vi gå hen og kigge på benet sammen end de andre, fordi de andre er stadig på jagt, og det ville være lidt synd, at jeg ødelagde det for dem. Så jeg tænker, at jeg lister hen og kigger på benet. Jeg tror, det var et godt skud. Jeg håber det. Skal vi kigge på det? Jeg tror, det var 18 meter eller så. Nej, 15 meter. Nej, det var ikke så langt. Prøv at se, om jeg kan finde min pil. Virkelig fedt. Jeg trak faktisk ikke engang, den var bag noget. Jeg trak bare, den lige dukkede hovedet ned, og den virkede roligt. Den havde kigget på mig flere gange, men den var altså ikke bange for mig. Den kunne simpelthen ikke se mig. Det er simpelthen så fedt, det her tøj. Det er kamotøj og det nye jagttøj, jeg har også rendt rundt med. Det er simpelthen så fedt, altså. Men det er også så sindssygt svært at få at filme og skyde samtidig. Og så særligt med så stor en buk på 15 meter. Og jeg var som sædvanlig også bare uheldig. Med filmen. Og det har jeg oplevet et par gange nu. Nu er det min døgnår fik jeg ikke med på filmen. Den sidste store buk med buen fik jeg heller ikke med på filmen. Så det er sådan lidt ærgerligt. Det er sådan lidt en øv oplevelse. Men samtidig er det jo super fedt, fordi det var en virkelig fed oplevelse, som jeg har for mig selv, som et minde. Og det er jo også fint. Fordi det var simpelthen så fedt, men den kom. Lige pludselig stod den der. Og jeg tænkte, skal jeg satse og prøve at tænde kameraet bag mig med en hånd? Men det er altså rimelig svært at tænde for det der professionelle kamera. Og så samtidig trykke på record og skulle kigge på skærmen, der står ved siden af mig. Jeg turde ikke, fordi den stod, den kom altså lige her. Lige pludselig var den der bare. Og den første buk, jeg kunne skyde, det var en lille buk. Den skød jeg ikke, fordi at jeg ikke havde kamera klar. Men min far sagde til mig, Steff, hvis der kommer en stor buk, så skyder du den altså bare, og så filmer du bagefter. Det, så vigtigt er det heller ikke, så. Så det gjorde jeg altså. Og det er jo, det er jo en af os lige meget, for det vigtigste er oplevelsen, og det var en fantastisk oplevelse. Men det er bare ærgerligt, det er tredje gang, jeg oplever det. Nu bliver man lidt småirriteret over det. Fordi man vil jo gerne dele det med andre. Selve skuddet. Og det er jo altså spændende at få sådan en stor buk ind på 15 meter. Og du står kun. Altså, der var jo ikke noget mellem os. Det var bare den og jeg. Og den kiggede på mig flere gange. Den så mig bare slet ikke. Det er simpelthen det er en rigtig fed oplevelse, det der med, at du bliver usynlig i skoven. Og går har jeg jo haft lams liggende lige foran mig, og flere gange har man set dyr tæt på, og det er simpelthen bare fedt det her. Og selvfølgelig er der nogen, der vil sige, hvordan kan du sådan lande at skyde dyrene, men det er jo ikke det med, at man slår dyret ihjel, det er jo ikke det, man er helt vild med her. Det er jo ikke drabet, det handler om. Kun. Der er så meget andet i det, ikke? Og det der at kunne overliste sådan stor en moden buk, som er så erfaren, og at den sanser er så meget bedre end min, det er altså bare super fedt. Det er virkelig spændende, og det er også så ja, man har virkelig, det er virkelig en stor oplevelse og et stort privilegium, at man kan få lov at gå ud i naturen og tage det kød, man spiser, det henter man ud i naturen. Og det er dyr, der har fået lov at leve, hvor de hører til, i naturen. Og det er den her måde, vi burde spise kød på, synes jeg. Og så smager det helt fantastisk. Vi har jo spist vildt kød alle de her dage, vi har været på jagt siden den 16. maj. I dag er det den... Hvad er det? Ej, jeg er lige myg. I dag er det vist den... Pas på, ikke ryk for meget kamera. Hvad er det, den 20. maj? Det var en fed oplevelse. Jeg glæder mig til, at de andre kommer, og jeg kan dele det med dem. Jeg går ikke efter bukken, før de kommer. Jeg vil gerne dele det med dem, og forhåbentlig også mine drenge. Det kan være... Ja, det kan være, at jeg går ind og vikker dem. De vil lige være med til det. Det vil de gerne. Det er jeg sikker på. Så jeg slukker lige kameraet, og så vender jeg lige tilbage senere.
Yeah, so when I came there, there was one roe, I think, standing there, right in front of the ladder. I think it was a female, because it ran just into the bushes. And then it stood there for a while, then it ran off, and a little later I heard a lamb in there.
Oh,
I think
yeah.
She put it down and then
yeah.
It left.
Mikael heard that as well, all the time.
Yeah, and then half an hour ago, I was sitting there and I heard a and I slowly looked up, and then I just heard it ran away. It was 35 meters in front of me. That must have been an old one, because I didn't barely move and he just ran off. He didn't look at all. He couldn't have seen me, because I was hitting with a tree.
It must be the wind.
Must be
because
the wind.
Weird thing is, the wind should have come from there.
Yeah.
And then, and I went into the forest, and when I sat, I felt the wind on my cheek going that way. And I thought, that's straight into where I want to shoot. But I was so lucky and unlucky, because I didn't get it on film. Because my charger, for once, I didn't put it correctly in, so it didn't charge the battery. So there were only 30% on the battery. So when I went out there, I thought, oh no, I have to save some battery. And so I waited for the right moment. You know when it's moment.
Yeah.
And this is not a lie. I stood there, and first of all, I got eaten by mosquitoes. So I thought, this is not gonna happen for me, because I stood like this all the time. And then the wind was going in that way, but that's always the days when something happens and the battery doesn't work and all that. But then I looked out there and I thought maybe something will come from there. And then I thought to myself, I have to turn on the camera now. And then I looked that way. The camera was here.
Yeah.
And then I looked that way and he was standing right in front of me, 20 meters, looking at me. And then I just looked down a little bit. And I was really struggling with myself, shall I shoot it, or shall I just let it go, or should I take the risk by turning the camera on like this, or like this. But there were no trees, because he was walking right in towards me, so no trees or anything, so I also thought, I can't draw to this one, looking at me many times, but he could not see me, and that was so cool. And the wind was going this way, and he came right there, so that was perfect. And then I just thought, okay, Dennis said, if there's a big one, just shoot it and then film afterward. So I was, okay, I said, okay, I'm just gonna do it. And it's just, he walked right towards me and I knew that he was gonna come this way. So that was gonna be the, I thought to myself, I can't draw to this one. But then he turned to the side and then he started eating and looked up. And I knew because we talked about that today. So he looked up and then he just turned down again and then I draw my bow. And then I thought about my my peeps or my pins.
Yeah.
And then I'm not that sure. I think actually he was closer than I thought.
Yeah.
But that's okay.
Yeah, that's okay.
Well, let's go and look at
it. It looked good. So yeah. I hope. And then he ran into the bushes. And a little later I heard some. Pfft.
Okay.
So I think it's good. But you never know.
No. Let's go look for it.
Yeah.
Okay. Nice.
So I took the path in.
Yeah,
and that's actually not that easy to crawl in. So I made a lot of noise, and then I was also like, it's not gonna happen today. Today we can learn, now we can take a different path. Okay, is it gonna be too far here?
That looks easy. That looks easy. Fine, I can see the arrow there behind there.
You see that?
Yeah.
I laid it where
Did you sit here or what?
No, come this way.
Throw the light over there. What is that?
But I filmed it on the other camera.
Can't see it.
That's 10 meters.
I think it's 10.
Yeah.
About 10 meters. But I can't see. I didn't look for blood. No. You can see the arrow here. But the arrow was laying like this, actually.
Was it laying like that?
Because I didn't see the... I couldn't see the... the Luminok from over there, and I thought that was weird, but it was laying like this. And now it's dry, of course, and I did like this. But you can see there's a lot of blood. He ran that way.
He ran that way?
In there.
Okay.
We have to look for blood, because I don't know.
It was all the way over here then.
Did you film it?
Yeah. You couldn't peek this, didn't you?
Yeah.
That's blood there.
Is that blood? Yeah, that's blood, yeah.
It looks a little bit like a lung, doesn't it?
No.
What does
it's
look
a lot
like?
Of small drops.
It's not much, but it's rather high, so it's it could be the lung. That's liver blood.
It's liver blood?
Yeah, liver.
Lots of blood. Look at this one.
No. That's blood.
Yeah, spray.
Yeah,
that looks
he's
good.
Losing a lot of blood now.
And here's blood. And blood there.
Blood here, blood here.
Yep.
Blood there.
Yep.
Did you get that?
Yep. Blood there.
Oh, a lot of blood there. That looks good.
Yeah. There's blood. Where's stick?
He ran here.
Yep.
Yeah. Oh. You can see that steps.
Yeah, like in Africa.
Okay.
There's a lot of blood here.
Oh, there's there. A lot of there. You probably crashed in there.
Leaves.
Must have crashed in there.
A lot of blood here.
Yeah.
And leaves underneath as well.
Oh, this is here. Very dark, huh?
And here as well.
There's one, yeah.
There was one such stuff.
Oh, right there.
Yes, it was there. Yes! Oh, that's so good we didn't stop. We just about to stop.
Hey,
Danish, you said let's stop.
I can't see you at all on the camera.
Let's stop now. You said, right?
Yeah. Yeah. Let's go
that's
that direction.
Weird. It's just second. You said stop now.
Yeah, and I said go that direction.
Go that direction.
We would have stepped
on
it.
Right there. Yes.
Put a light on the animal then.
Oh, that's so cool. Oh, it looks like really behind. Yeah.
Oops, Steph. Yeah. Let me come around you here.
Yeah, because it was too high, because he was a lot closer than I thought.
Yeah, high, that's one thing, but did it go straight through him or what?
Yeah, it must have.
Take that.
That's the red bug, this one here. Which one is it?
It's...
I see it. Oh, yeah. He's a beauty, huh?
Yeah. Which one is that? Did we ever see this one? Oh, yeah.
Yeah, that's the one. Try to see that one.
Yeah, that's the one we saw on the trail cam. Nice.
It's a beauty.
Yeah. So good we found it. Huh?
Are you happy?
Yeah, really. Really happy. I'm so happy we found this one. We're just about to stop.
It didn't run in front of us.
No.
It has been dead for a while.
Yeah, because it's really stiff.
Yeah.
It's a beautiful buck, huh?
You got it.
Yeah.
Nice.
That was a nice hunt. Not the best.
Try to turn it around. Let's see where the arrow went down.
Pull it out from here.
Just turn it around.
Well, the arrow actually... Then
a little better on the other side.
Yeah, that's a good.
Yeah.
That's a good.
So it actually hit the lung on this side.
Yeah.
Yeah, oh, try to look at that.
Yes, that's beautiful.
Beautiful buck.
It's a beautiful buck.
Congratulations.
Thank you. Thank you so much. Yeah.
Stort tillykke, Stephanie.
Yeah, it's been dead for a while, yeah. Tak for det.
Fedt, man.
Med buen, det var fedt.
Ja. Den kom ind på, du så den på 20 meter først. Yeah. Og så gik den faktisk imod dig.
Ja. Yeah.
Så kom den ind på en 15 meter og kiggede væk, så trak du buen, og så stod den faktisk på 10 meter
på
skødet.
Ja, 10 meter, så den var lidt tættere, end jeg regnede.
Ja, det har den altså.
Den var lidt højere. Og jeg kunne ikke se fronten af den. Så jeg tror, det er derfor, jeg trukket automatisk lidt længere tilbage på kroppen.
Ja.
Fordi
ja.
Jeg kunne ikke se, jeg kunne kun se forbenet.
Ja, måske, ja.
Lige halvdelen af forbenet. Og så tror jeg, man automatisk ikke tør at gå for tæt på det træ, du skal skyde.
Ja, det er klart.
Så man trækker lidt længere tilbage.
Ja, det er sådan instinktivt, du har trukket lidt tilbage. Det er. Altså udgangshullet er jo
åbenmærket. Og når den så står tættere på, end hvad du har skudt din pind ind til 20 meter, så er klart, så vil den jo være lidt højt, jo.
Ja.
Så. Men den er død jo.
Flot, flot, flot bugt.
Ja. Den er rigtig fin.
Den er høj, hva'?
Ja. Actually, it's not even a line. We actually follow the steps a lot.
Yeah.
Sometimes you can see it.